So the majority of spin crossover, the majority of spin crossover systems are systems with iron two ions. This crossover is characterized by the transition between states A1A and 5Q2, the significant difference in spin and orbital degeneracy. In this case, the crossover shows different types of temperature dependence of the high spin fraction. The transition is more pronounced than in cobalt ions, and it is not accompanied by the change in the crystal symmetry with temperature. Therefore, the deformation arising from the low high spin transition is mainly a full symmetric one, without change of symmetry, crystal symmetry. The coupling with the iron ions with tetragonal or trigonal vibrations plays a secondary role and can be neglected. Next. What's the issue? So another situation happens in spin crossover cobalt compounds. The low spin cobalt 2e state contains only one unpaired electron and six paired up electrons. The high spin cobalt ion contains three unpaired electrons and two pairs of paired up electrons. The states are 2e and 4t1. The difference between the spins of participating states on cobalt ion is much smaller as compared with that for the high spin low states of the iron 2 ion. Coupling of the ground 2e state with the Jahn-Teller tetragonal mole leads to additional stabilization of this state and makes the condition for observation of spin transition more rigid than for iron ions. The smaller change in the spin associated with the transition and the operation of the Jahn-Teller effect and the states involved in this spin conversion lead to special features of spin crossover in cobalt 2 compounds. Here is the picture of one of the cobalt compounds which will be considered in our work. The aims are to develop a model that accounts for both the spin crossover phenomena and the Jahn-Teller effect in cobalt 2 compounds, to explain on the basis of the model the observed behavior of the three compounds obtained by the group of Kim Dunbar. So the system demonstrated spin crossover belongs to the class of molecular crystals. The vibrations of a molecular crystal can be subdivided into types, the molecular one and the intermolecular type. The role of these vibrations in the spin transformation is different. While the molecular vibrations directly coupled to electron, to the electronic shells of spin crossover ions form the energy spectra of these ions, their intermolecular vibrations transmit the local strain appearing due to the spin transition throughout the crystal. In our earlier papers, it was suggested that we can replace these two types of vibrations by introduction of two types of strains. These strains are shown here, C1 and C2. C1 is the strain characterizing the more rigid space, which contains the cobalt ion and the ligands of the nearest surrounding. And C2 characterizes the elastic model of the intermolecular space, which is solved and gives the possibility to the spin crossover ion to expand during the transition. The Hamiltonian of the crystal contains the Hamiltonian of isolated cobalt ions, the cooperative electron deformational coupling, as well as the electron vibration interaction in the Hamiltonian 3 lattice vibrations. The latter terms are introduced in the total Hamiltonian, since the cobalt ions in the octahedral surrounding interact with shifting vibrations of the surrounding in both low spin and high spin states. At the same time, the electron vibration coupling does not mix the ground low spin and the excited high spin state, and this is clear. The states possess different spin multiplicity. The Hamiltonian of isolated spin crossover ions includes the spin orbital interaction within the cubic 41 triplet of the high spin cobalt ion, the splitting of the ground T2E term of the low spin cobalt ion by the low symmetry crystal field, the Zeeman interaction in the high spin configuration. You see this term accounts for the unquenched orbital angular momentum of the cobalt ion. The Zeeman interaction in the low spin configuration here is the 2E state, it does not possess an orbital angular momentum, and the energy gap between the high spin 41 term and the ground 42 term. The matrices are special for the high spin state and for the low spin state. Then we introduce the electron deformation interaction. In this case, we introduce two types of electron deformation interactions. For the high spin 41 state, we introduce the interaction with the A1 strand, full symmetric strand, which does not change the symmetry. And for the E state, we introduce the interaction with the A1 and the E strands. The values, the tensors of these interactions are shown here. The coupling with the E strand is strong for the low spin D7 configuration with a singular electron in the E orbital and gives large energy stabilization due to this strand. The effect of the E strand is less noticeable for the high spin state. X-ray data shows structural compression along the fourth order cubic axis, so we take the U component only in our consideration of the entire of deformation. Then we write the Hamiltonian of electron deformation interaction. First, it was written as a function of the stress, then minimized over the stress, and we obtain the two terms of inter-ion interaction. The first term describes the electron deformation of cooperative interaction arising from the full symmetric deformation, and the second term describes the trend. Then the problem is solved in the mean field approximation to reduce the problem of interacting cobalt ions to one cobalt ions. Here are the mean values of the distortion produced by the full symmetric strand and by the tetragonal strand. Rho is the density operator. The partition function represents a product of the electronic statistical sum and vibrational sum. The vibrational sum is shown here. We take into account the 15 vibrational modes, and for them we use their frequencies obtained by DFT calculations. Then we estimate the interaction, the constant of interaction with the totally symmetric strand. The operator of the totally symmetric strand is shown here, and the constant it can be expressed through the parameter the cubic crystal field parameter in the high spin state. The same is for the low spin state. The parameter is shown here, and the value of the cubic crystal parameter used is also shown. We take into account that all three compounds have different volumes falling on one cobalt ion, and take also the elastic modeling from literature. The elastic modeling C1 and C2, C3, C1 and C4, C2 and C4, they enter in the expression for the cooperative electron deformation parameter. So we obtain the values for the electron deformation parameters shown in the slide. Next, we should estimate the characteristic parameter which characterizes the coupling of the cobalt ion with the tetragonal strain. Here it's shown the parameter of the tetragonal, the constant of interaction with the tetragonal strain V2. It is expressed through the electronic matrix element of the vibration, tetragonal VU vibration. And this is the parameter of electron deformational interaction on the account of the tetragonal strain. So, because we have the compression of the complex. Therefore, for estimation of the strength, we use the operator of interaction with the tetragonal strain. It contains two parts, the contribution of the point charge, and the contribution of the exchange charge. S4 and S4 are the overlap integrals and their derivatives. To calculate the matrix element of interaction, we use the following wave function and the parameter J, characterizing the covalence effect, we calculate from the parameter, which is taken from experimental data. We obtain for these compounds the parameter J2, which characterizes the catalytic interaction with the tetragonal strain. And now here, we show the results obtained. The sets of the best fit parameters for all three compounds reasonably describe the experimental curve from one compound to another. As the fitting parameters, we use the energy gap between the high spin and low spin state, the energy gap that determines the splitting of the ETM, and the initial concentration of cobalt ions, which are in the high spin state from the very beginning. The calculating fractions, mu high spin of ions, which are in the high spin from the very beginning, are in good agreement with the observed ones. The inequality between these values obtained the date of the best fit procedure is confirmed by the experimental data. The gaps obey the inequality, the gaps between the high spin and low spins obey the inequality shown in the set. That leads to the situation in which, starting from 200K, the highest is the KT curve for the compound one, and the lowest one is the heating curve for the compound two. And this is in line with experimental data. The obtained negative values of the parameter data correspond to the axial compression of the local octahedron, stabilization of the V component of the 2EW. The calculated parameters of electron deformation interaction are also in line with the experimental data. So the conclusions, to describe the observed temperature increase of the magnetic susceptibility and cobalt compounds, along with the interaction with the full symmetric deformation, accompanying the spin transition, the interaction with the tetragonal model for the low spin state, it was necessary to introduce in the developed model. The mentioned two interactions play a different role in the spin transformation in the cobalt compounds and compete with one another. The coupling with the full symmetric strain reduces the distance between the states participating in the transition and, in fact, facilitates the transition. The role of the tetragonal mode is different since it splits the ground low spin E level, increases the energy gap between the states participating in the transition. It leads in main to the gradual type transitions and cobalt compounds. And so we acknowledge the support of the National Agency for Research and Development of the Moldova. Thank you for attention. Hello.
Okay, thank you, Professor Klokishner. Are there any questions, please? So, if not, I may try. Can you have some idea what would happen around sub-Kelvin temperature, for instance, when you start?
With very, very low temperatures. So, okay. We use the experimental data, which really show very low temperatures. I cannot say about the situation which happens on the in the other temperature interval. I can speak only about the situation which I know from the experimental data. At low temperatures, the system is in the low spin. Then, due to cooperative interaction, it passes to the high spin state. The transition is gradual because the electron cooperative electron deformation interaction is not so strong. If the cooperative electron deformation is stronger, we can observe another type of transition. Besides, in this system, the difference between the spin states is very low. And so we see small degrees in the Calci product. The transitions, spin crossover transitions, are more pronounced for iron ions, for iron ions, ions where the spin of the low state is zero, and the spin of the excited state is two.
Okay, thanks, Sue.